So what kind of processors are we going to build? Let's assume that the major design constraint is power. Why are traditional CPU-like processors not the most energy-efficient processors? Well, traditional CPUs have very complicated control hardware. This allows flexibility and performance, but as control hardware gets more complicated, it's increasingly expensive in terms of power and design complexity. So if we want the most bang for the buck in terms of computation for a fixed amount of power, we might instead choose to build simpler control structures and instead take those transistors and devote them to supporting more computation in the data path. So if we want the most bang for the buck in terms of computation for a fixed amount of power, we might choose to build simpler control structures and instead devote those transistors to supporting more computation in the data path. And the way that we're going to build that data path in a GPU is by building a large number of parallel compute units. Individually, those compute units are small, simple, and power efficient. These are the chickens. But we can put a very large number of them on a single chip. And the challenge to us in this class, and more generally in the computing industry, is to program them in such a way that they can all work together to solve complex problems.